we can see all around us the evidence of more and more environmental disasters. We read about it in the papers, floods, fires, storms.
Today, we really are transitioning the global energy system. We've gone from wood to coal to fossil fuels. We need to transition the global energy system to less carbon intensive and less dense energy sources.
Renewables will have to grow by 50% by the mid-2020s, and this is going to fuel exceptional growth in things like solar and wind. Offshore wind is just one example. People expect to see double-digit compound annual growth rates going all the way out to 2040. That's an exceptional sort of growth profile that's very hard to find in other places.
We have rising population, rising incomes, urbanization, where we see energy demand rising by as much as 40%.
Even before we talk about reducing the amount of carbon that's currently in the atmosphere, we already have an incremental 4% growth per year that we need to offset.
Today, energy-related CO2 emissions stand at about 33 gigatons. And what we need to do in order to just come close to the Paris 2-degree accord is that we need to go by 2050 to about 9.8 gigatons.
If you're willing to take the volatility that can come with a long-only vehicle, we think that through cycle, the growth and investment opportunity here is quite strong. You know, we're seeing increasingly assets shift into sustainability.
What this means is about $29 trillion of investment until 2050. And that is why the timing today for energy transition is right. And this is also why we think that this theme is only going to get stronger and broader and more important for investors to be part of.
We invest in three very exciting areas. One is the decarbonization of the energy system. The other is the decentralization of the energy system. And the last is the digitalization of the energy system.
One being renewable energy production, two being energy efficiency and technology, and three in energy storage, transportation, and infrastructure. There's a variety of subsectors, 24, that we've defined as being interesting and specifically targeting the global energy system.
We think one unique feature about our team is that it's been together for so long. My co-PM and myself have been working together since 2001. We've had a lot of experience not only in developing quantitative models, but growing and managing proprietary investment businesses and investing in these core areas of energy, materials, agriculture, and industrials that encompasses the stocks that we look at today.
In order to understand where we're going, you need to understand where we're coming from. Ed and I have not only invested within all the green stuff, but also had a previous history of investing in the brown stuff. We need to have a view on what is going on in coal markets, what's going on in gas markets, what's going on in oil markets, and only then do you know how profound the opportunity is in terms of where we're going.
We think BNP Asset Management is a fantastic firm from which to be launching this vehicle because they're so believable when it comes to environmental investing.
BNP has a more than 15-year history investing sustainably and responsibly.
They have a very large sustainability research center that we are involved with quite closely.
We, as well as the rest of BNP Paribas Asset Management, are now excluding thermal coal companies as well as power generation companies with an excessive carbon footprint.
And they have a long history in developing quantitative practices, something that we also do increasingly with our investment approach.
Ed and I have an investment process that we've used for the past 20 years. We start by looking at macro and regulatory themes as that can affect the companies we invest in. From there on, once we've identified this, we move down the funnel and looking at industry and commodity and making sure that supply and demand within these industries are either things that we can benefit for or a tail risk for the companies we invest in.
At that point, we layer in some quantitative tools. We've spent a lot of time developing these in conjunction with our fundamental approach, and indeed we have a dedicated developer and data scientist on the team. This further reduces our universe to a very manageable subset where we can use our time most effectively to do deeper fundamental work. At this point, we also layer in tactical considerations in terms of short interest and positioning, leveraging our backgrounds not only as investors, but also as people that have operated trading in the markets.
Finally, and importantly, portfolio construction and risk management is there to give the portfolio a better construct and make sure that it's solid through cycle in different market environments.
Another key part of our reporting process is to look at SDG alignment, investment by investment. And here we take a data-driven approach, really looking through the full list of 169 development goals in order to make sure that they're explicitly aligned with detailed revenue segmentation analysis in the portfolio.
The way that we qualify stocks for the energy transition is that every single company we invest in has more than 20% of their revenues or CapEx in what we deem as being environmentally sustainable revenues.
This isn't just happening now. This has already been happening. It's imperative that investors start to invest in line with these ideas right now.
Investing in energy transition is a great opportunity. It's an investment universe that really is geared towards giving you outsized returns because you have a theme where the wind is in your back.